Hi everyone, today in this video we are going to discuss about bilirubin test. What is bilirubin? Bilirubin is a brownish yellow pigment that is required for breakdown of the fat that is present in the food. For the digestion of the fat, bilirubin is secreted through the bile. But this bilirubin within the body can exist in two types. One type of bilirubin is present as free form within the blood, which should be protected. So it is associated with albumin. This type of pigment present in the blood is called as unconjugated bilirubin. And this unconjugated bilirubin is water insoluble. So it is not directly involving in digestion of fat. That's why this type of bilirubin is called as indirect bilirubin. Second form of bilirubin is present within the liver, where it is conjugated with the sugars by glycosidic linkage, so that it can produce a water-soluble form of bilirubin, and it is called as conjugated bilirubin. And now this conjugated bilirubin is responsible for digestion of fatty material within the food. That's why it is called as direct bilirubin. In this way, these two forms are exist within the body. But in the bilirubin test, we can estimate both unconjugated as well as conjugated bilirubin. So this total amount is called as total bilirubin. Now let us see when this test is required, when this bilirubin levels are elevated. One of the important clinical condition is the jaundice, where we can observe elevated levels of bilirubin, which produce various symptoms that can particularly affect the eye, resulting in the yellowish discoloration of the eye. Similarly, yellowish discoloration of the skin and some unexpected weakness, fatigue can be observed in the patients. Some abdominal pain, nausea, decreased appetite which reduces the weight. So weight loss can be observed within the patients. Dark colored urine because of excretion of bilirubin within the urine. Chills and fever, all these symptoms can be observed with increased levels of bilirubin, which is categorized as jaundice. And this jaundice can also be observed in the newborns, which is called as neonatal jaundice. So particularly the newborns born before the gestational period, if a pregnant woman delivered with a gestational period less than 35 weeks, the newborns may have less weight, less development of liver and excretory system, so that the bilirubin levels are increased due to lack of sufficient conjugation, which results in neonatal jaundice. Again, in the neonates, we can observe yellowish discoloration of the skin, eye, itching of eyes, some chills, fever, decreased appetite. All these symptoms can also be observed in the neonates, which should be thoroughly controlled. Apart from the jaundice, bilirubin levels can also be elevated in the liver disorders such as hepatitis. Any inflammation of the liver may result in excessive levels of bilirubin, or liver cirrhosis. Similarly, any obstruction of bile, so any gallbladder disorders which results in the obstruction of bile leading to elevated levels of bilirubin, or in the patients with severe alcoholism where the liver is affected, resulting in the decreased catabolism, resulting in the elevated levels of this bilirubin, or any hemolytic disorders which results in the breakdown of RBC leading to release of hemoglobin, from which heme and finally bilirubin can be released, resulting in the elevated levels. So any of these conditions may elevate the bilirubin levels. In such conditions, bilirubin test can be done in order to assess any abnormality within the patients. Now let us see what is the role of bilirubin. Just we have seen that bilirubin is responsible for breakdown of the fat, but how it is going to be formed, how it is going to be released, and how it is going to be excreted. The important source of bilirubin is the senescent RBC. When the red blood cells lifespan is over, then they are going to be ruptured and they can release hemoglobin. Now this hemoglobin, which is released from the RBC, can be further cleaved such that the protein part is going to be removed and it can release the pigment heme. This heme can be oxidized such that it is converted into one of the component bilirubin. Now this bilirubin is a water soluble metabolite, but this is further reduced such that it can release bilirubin. Now this bilirubin is present as a free form within the blood and it is unconjugated, but it is water insoluble. Because of water insolubility, it cannot directly involve in the digestion of fat. So this type of bilirubin is called as indirect bilirubin or unconjugated bilirubin. Now this unconjugated bilirubin should be protected within the blood, which is going to be transported into the liver so that it is going to be converted into conjugated bilirubin. Now this unconjugated bilirubin can be transported into the liver where it is undergoing the glycosylation with sugar moieties such that it is converted into conjugated bilirubin, which is then stored into the gallbladder. In this way, bilirubin is converted into conjugated bilirubin within the liver and it is stored into the gallbladder. Then it is released into the small intestine. Within the large intestine, it can be converted into another metabolite, urobilinogen. And it is also converted into another form, stercobilin. Now, this stercobilin can be excreted through the feces and urobilinogen can be excreted through the renal system where it is secreted along with the urine. But here, most of the urobilinogen is transported into the liver through the enterohepatic circulation. In this way, bilirubin can be converted into two forms, urobilinogen and stercobilin, which are excreted through urine and feces respectively. Because of any dysfunction at any of these pathways may result in the elevated levels of bilirubin. So liver disorders such as hepatitis, liver cirrhosis or severe alcoholism or any gallbladder disorders such as obstruction of gallbladder or any renal failure, all these conditions may elevate the bilirubin levels, resulting in the various symptoms resembling the jaundice. How it is estimated? One of the methods for estimation of bilirubin is the Malloy-Evelyn method, where the sample is collected and serum is going to be separated. Now to this serum, a reagent is going to be added, which is nothing but sulfonylic acid that is treated with sodium nitrate plus HCl at 0 to 4 degrees centigrade, such that it forms a diazo reagent. And the diazotized sulfonylic acid is then added to the serum sample where it reacts with the bilirubin so that it is converted into a product which produces some purple color. This purple color is because of formation of azobilirubin due to the formation of azolinkase. In this way, the bilirubin present in the sample can be detected by this method, and this reaction with the diazotized sulfonylic acid is called as Vandenberg reaction. But in this reaction, the diazotized reagent only reacts with water-soluble bilirubin. So in this test, we can get the color development within 30 seconds. But this test estimates only the direct bilirubin, which is water-soluble. So indirect bilirubin is not estimated here. Whatever the color produced is because of only direct bilirubin, where the intensity of the purple color is measured by spectrophotometer, which is directly proportional to the concentration of direct bilirubin within the sample. But still the same method can be used to estimate total as well as indirect bilirubin. In order to estimate total bilirubin, now we are going to take the serum sample which is mixed with methanol. By addition of methanol, unconjugated bilirubin is dissolved. Now by addition of the diazotized sample, it can undergo the color reaction to produce azobilirubin. Again here the same chemical reaction is involved, Vandenberg reaction, where the bilirubin is converted into azobilirubin. But here the diazotized reagent reacts with both conjugated as well as unconjugated bilirubin so that the reaction takes slowly, and for the development of purple color it takes at least 30 minutes. So in this method we can estimate the total bilirubin levels present in the sample. Second method is there to estimate the total bilirubin levels directly, which is nothing but Jendrasik graph method. In this method, the serum sample is mixed with various reagents such as caffeine, benzoate and acetate, so that now the reagent can react with both conjugated as well as unconjugated bilirubin. Again here we are going to use the diazotized sulfonylic acid, which is reacting with both conjugated as well as unconjugated bilirubin so that it produces purple color due to formation of azobilirubin. This method estimates the total bilirubin levels present in the serum sample. What are the normal values? The normal values of bilirubin are variable with the laboratory conditions. Generally, the direct bilirubin levels fall less than 0.3 mg per deciliter, and total bilirubin levels are variable from 0.1 to 1.2 mg per deciliter. From these two values, we can also estimate the indirect bilirubin or unconjugated bilirubin, which is nothing but total minus conjugated bilirubin. So this unconjugated bilirubin may fall less than 0.7 milligrams per deciliter. But again, these normal values may slightly variable with laboratory conditions. So that's about this bilirubin test, which is used to estimate the total bilirubin levels, direct bilirubin levels, as well as unconjugated bilirubin levels within the serum. When these bilirubin levels are elevated, it may produce some jaundice, resulting in symptoms such as yellowish discoloration of skin, eye, itching of eyes, decreased appetite, fatigue, weight loss, abdominal pain, nausea, some chills and fever can also be observed. And this jaundice can also be observed within the neonates due to decreased conjugation and decreased excretion of bilirubin. And bilirubin levels are also elevated in other conditions such as liver cirrhosis, hepatitis, severe alcoholism, or obstruction of gallbladder, hemolytic disorders. In all these conditions, bilirubin levels are elevated, which can be estimated by this bilirubin test. In this test, we can use the digitized reagent such as sulfonylic acid plus NaNO2 plus HCl, which reacts with the bilirubin to produce azobilirubin with purple color. Serum sample can give the estimation of direct bilirubin, but when this is added with solvents such as caffeine, benzoate and acetate, then it can give the total bilirubin levels present in the serum. In this way, we can estimate either direct, indirect and total bilirubin levels present in the serum. So that's about this bilirubin test. Hope you have enjoyed this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to our channel. Share this video with your friends. Post your comments in the comment box. Thank you for watching this video.